Thank you. It's Friday. It's Kevin. It's live from lockdown. Thank you for joining me. Nice to have you here. I can see a few people saying hello already. Right on, right on. Happy Friday. Happy live from lockdown. This is my almost weekly live stream coming to you from my lockdown studio. Somewhat nomadic these days, lockdown studio here in Toronto. I'm sitting on the traditional territory of the Wendat and Anishinaabeg First Nations, the people of the Haudenosaunee Confederacy. The Mississaugas of the New Credit, and the Métis Nation. And it is those First Nations that have kept this land sacred and safe and whole since time immemorial. And it's their enduring hospitality and generosity which makes it possible for people like me to be here. And for that, I am eternally grateful. And so, an hour or so of music and words, first and foremost, in the spirit of justice and reconciliation with those people. And speaking of generosity, as I do these days, I want to say a special thanks again to Ratspace Rehearsal and Recording Studios and Robin Easton and his partner Rebecca Campbell, who are the hosts of my Live from Lockdown studio these days. They've made me very welcome and created this amazing space for me. Huge thanks to them. This is most definitely the best rehearsal space in Toronto. And if you are a musician or someone else needing some space, very well-equipped place to do some work and to do some work in the context of really appropriate COVID precautions, this is the place to be. If you check the notes on the side of the page, Robin's phone numbers and the Ratspace website are all there. Please check it out. Sorry for hitting the mic. Please give them some support. Times are tough for everybody in this kind of business. One of the things they do here is video shoots, and yesterday there was a big video shoot, so we cleared the whole studio out and then reset. So if you're a regular watcher, if you watched the last couple of weeks, the setting's a little bit different. I got a little more elbow room. We had to pack up everything and then set it up again. So hence the changes. I hope you like it. I haven't had a chance to rehang my principles of a just recovery, but again, you know what those are if you've been watching. Yeah, thank you. That was Nostalgia in Times Square off the top of the show. A great kind of blues by the fabulous Charles Mingus, bassist, composer, musical genius from from the United States of America, who died a number of years ago, but collaborator, really, really important figure in the world of jazz and popular music. Which puts me to mind of Playtime and Tom Bancroft and Graham Stephan and Mario Caribe and Martin Kershaw, those great musicians in Edinburgh who do a weekly show and a weekly live stream these days, after years of doing a live show in Edinburgh. Last week, November 5th, their Playtime show was a tribute to Charles Mingus, and interestingly, they opened with that same tune, Nostalgia in Times Square. So I want to say hello to them, and thanks for their ongoing musical inspiration. And no bad messages. Everything seems to be working. Lots of people saying hello. Thank you very much. Check the stream. Yeah, we seem to be working. Let me know if it's not. All right. I am going to continue with another standard. This is a tune written by Toots Thielemans, who's a Belgian guitarist, although better known as a harmonica player, really fantastic jazz harmonica player. Who'd have thunk? It's another kind of blues. This one's in 3/4 time and in the key of G if you're playing along. Some people do it in B flat, but G sits a bit more nicely on this instrument. This is a tune called Bluesette. Thank you. Suzette by the great Toots Thielemans. Kind of his one-hit composition, but a really fun tune to play. Hope you got that. Hope you got to play along. I'm going to say, as I do every week these days, that this is a tough business to be in, being a live musician in the age of COVID. And if you are able to make a donation, if you've got an income and you're able to share some of that and support some of the live art that's going on, those of us who are trying to do that really, really appreciate it. No pressure if you can't, and much appreciated if you can. I've got a lot of very generous friends who have been supporting me doing this, and I hugely appreciate it and don't expect it. And I'm always very pleasantly surprised by your support, so thank you. Check the links on the side of the page. You'll see a link to my PayPal account and my Ko-Fi account. And if you're in Canada, you can even just send me an e-transfer. Thanks for that. And you know, if this week you want to support somebody else, there's a lot of people trying to do this. Lots of great live streams out there. Again, farther down the page on the notes, in the notes that I added, I've got some other suggestions of some really great live music to check out online. Please do that. Share the love and share your resources if you can. Help some people out trying to make some music. I was wearing my mask off the top of the show. I'm alone in this place, so don't think I need to be at the moment, but trying to make a point, because, man, things are getting worse out there, aren't they? Here's another tune from the American Songbook, a jazz tune that people like to play that I'm going to do as a bossa nova. I think I've done this once before on the show a number of months ago. And I like to try to play a bossa nova every week, playing my nylon string guitar. This is a tune I just learned this. Apparently this tune was actually written for Billie Holiday. I thought it came from a show, but it didn't. It's a standard called Loverman. And apparently first written and first recorded by Billie Holiday. That's certainly the recording that I first learned it from. As I say, I'm going to take a run at a kind of bossa nova version. Loverman. Thank you. Lover man, oh where can you be? There you go.
Beautiful tune.
In an attempt to be a kind of a long form bossa nova. That's tougher. I haven't played that in a while, and I just thought about doing it last night, and it's a bit harder than I remembered. So, hope I got through that one okay. So, very important birthday wish this week. Gonna occupy much of the rest of the show. Oh, if I can get myself organized. With a bit of a backstory. So, I grew up in the Anglican Church. Pretty deeply immersed. Quite surrounded, in fact. And it's not an institution with which I have much connection anymore, except through some friends and family. But a place that I learned a ton. I am eternally grateful for a whole lot that I learned as being part of the Anglican Church for the first few decades of my life. A lot of opportunities, a lot of chances to travel places and meet people and do a lot of things. And one of the things I learned in that institution is the power of ritual. A really important way that we humans gather and do things and do ritual action, and how potent those kind of activities can become. Now, I wouldn't want to be so bold as to suggest that anything related to life from lockdown has attained the status of ritual just yet. But there are some things that it's nice to know you can count on just about every week. One of those things is that just about every Friday, sometime around now in the show, I'll reach for my mandolin, and Dave Lipsy will type mandolin yippers in the comments on the side of the Facebook page. And I love that. And it's to the point where friends like Linda Partington will do it herself if Dave misses it. Well, Dave had a birthday yesterday, and I want to wish massive happy birthday to Dave Lipsy. Dave is a fantastic friend, a generous and wonderful guy with a lot of skills and a lot of love to give. He happens to be married to Ola Weeb, who I gave a shout out to last week. There's a lot of love and generosity in that house. And I'm going to play a couple of birthday dedications for Dave. And the first one, just because I'm picking up my mandolin, of course, had to be. So happy birthday, Dave. I hope you can stick around to the end of the show. I got a couple of things for you. But first of all, my weekly mandolin extravaganza. Well, that would be overstating it. My weekly attempt to play something on the mandolin. Louise Bevan, I think you're listening because you posted earlier. You said your mandolin practice. This one's in A minor if you want to play along. This is a request from Judy Shand, another friend I've mentioned often, who's one of those people who keeps the requests coming. Thank you, Judy, very much, and all of you who send requests regularly. As I keep saying, this lockdown looks like it's going to continue, looks like it's getting worse. This pandemic is not going away fast, so I'm going to keep doing this, and all the inspiration I can get to think about new tunes to play is much appreciated. This is a traditional Newfoundland folk tune, apparently. I believe it comes from the island of Newfoundland off the east coast of Canada. Judy tells me she used to sing it in her youth. And it's been recorded by a bunch of people. There's a bunch of examples of it around, including the great Jane Sibbery, who is a former colleague of Rebecca Campbell, one of my hosts here at the Radspace Recording Studios. And one of the few times when I'm going to play a tune on the mandolin that does not come from the collection of charts that my good friend Stuart Seidel in Vancouver has been sending me. This is a tune called She's Like the Swallow. And I had to learn it the old-fashioned way by listening to the recording and figuring it out. I hope you like it. Here we go. Just a bit of A minor ambience to fill the room. So. Thank you. like to swallow. There you go. Or my version thereof. Judy, I hope you recognize that. Maybe you could sing along. Another one. I just learned this week, and we'll try to learn that one a little better. Thank you for listening to that. Check in. Oh, look at that. Thank you. All you people saying hello. I really appreciate it. If you watch me regularly, you know this. I don't really pay attention to the comments while I'm playing the show because I just have enough on my mind and I can't respond. And friends of mine know to send me a text if there's something going really awry with the show. And otherwise, I promise, I go through the show later. I read all the comments. I reply where I can. And I really appreciate the love and support that a bunch of people send me all the time. Thanks to Judy for the request. Happy birthday to Dave Lipsy. Thanks to Stuart for always sending me mandolin tunes, even if I didn't play one of yours this week. I should also say Stuart has sent me a heartfelt request that I might do a Leonard Cohen tune called Democracy last week. And I just didn't feel up for the musical and lyrical challenge of that one. I'm not sure I still do. And to be honest, as that song says, not sure that democracy is quite coming fast enough in the USA. But thanks to all my mandolin friends and all the people who support me trying to get my fingers and my head around this crazy little instrument. Another way, of course, that you can support people in this business is by buying our recordings. And every week I tell you about a place called Bandcamp, a fantastic website that has a bunch of great music on it. You can get my recordings, including an album of mine with a bunch of my compositions called Share the Wealth, and an album by my band, The Special Interest Group. Both of those are there. And again, the links are on the side of the page. And there's a whole bunch of other great music there. Please check those out. If you're going to buy some music online, I really encourage you to do it at Bandcamp. They are a much more musician-friendly place than Spotify and iTunes and some of those big companies. They take a much lower cut of the money that you send, so some money actually gets to those of us who are making the music. Imagine that. Check that out. Here comes a tune that the Special Interest Group does. It's not on that record. This is a tune. Do I still want that loop? No, I'm going to get rid of that loop and fix that. In the old days, I had another camera on my feet so you could see what I was doing, but my poor computer couldn't quite handle it. So I took it out. But I do have lots of things going on down here and lots of things to pay attention to. Here's a tune by Nick Lowe, a great tune by Nick Lowe that is perhaps better known even by the version that Elvis Costello recorded a number of years ago. A couple of dedications for this one. One is my sister Bronwyn, my fabulous sister Bronwyn, who lives in Vancouver, who also often sends requests, and she sent one request for this one just last week, just as I thought I should play it. I also want to say that while I was doing some research about birthday dedications for my good friend Dave Lipsy, this song didn't come up, although I did hear that he likes this tune, so I hope he does too, and I hope you do. As I say, the Special Interest Group does this tune. Lots of people have done this tune. It asks a disarmingly appropriate question these days. What's so funny about peace, love, and understanding? And I gotta say, just in my warm-up, about an hour and a half ago, it became clear to me that I was about 3 days late changing the strings on this guitar, and I'm having a hard time keeping the G string in particular of this guitar in tune. And given that this tune is in G, that's an important string, so I just really hope it lasts, and I hope you like it. What's so funny about peace, love, and understanding? I walk through this wicked world, searching for light in the darkness of insanity. Ask myself, is all hope lost? Is there only pain and hatred and misery? One thing I wanna know, what's so funny about peace, love, and understanding?
I walk on through troubled times. My spirit gets so downhearted sometimes. Where are the strong? Who are the trusted? Where is the harmony, sweet harmony? 'Cause each time I feel it slipping away, just makes me wanna cry. What's so funny about peace, love, and understanding? Oh, what's so funny about peace, love, and understanding? Trusted. Where is the harmony, sweet harmony? 'Cause each time I feel it slipping away, it just makes me wanna cry. What's so funny about peace, love, and understanding? Oh, what's so funny about peace, love, and understanding? What's so funny about peace, love, and understanding?
Sorry about that G string. Sometimes it goes sharp and sometimes it goes flat, and it's hard to fix on the fly. Anyway, what is so funny about peace, love, and understanding? Thank you, Elvis Costello and Nick Lowe. Happy birthday, Dave Lipsy. Thanks, Bronwyn. Yeah. All right. Wow. Tunes are going by fast today. This might be a shorter one. I'm going to switch back to my nylon string guitar. I'm going to play you a jazz ballad, and then... Well, we got a couple more things coming up. Thanks again for sticking around. Ha! I just noticed that Ola said Dave was singing along. That's a very good sign. Glad to hear that. I'm going to change it back to the jazz mode for a moment and play you a ballad just to kind of mellow things out. Here's a tune by the great Billy Strayhorn. Billy Strayhorn was a brilliant, brilliant composer and arranger, longtime associate of Duke Ellington. A man that was way ahead of his time culturally and musically and harmonically in all kinds of ways. Created a lot of really beautiful music. And I'm going to play a tune that, that I've really loved for a long time and been playing for a long time. I actually recorded this on my first album, which is an album that's just about out of print and almost impossible to find, although I think it might still be on iTunes, believe it or not. An album called Jam that I recorded back in the 1990s when I didn't really know what I was doing. This is a tune called Chelsea Bridge. I should also say that there's a town called Chelsea, Old Chelsea, in the province of Quebec near the city of Ottawa. And right very close to where my son Caleb works. And my good friend John Geggy, a fantastic bassist who lives in Ottawa, used to live there and live near the bridge in the old village. And he and a vocalist named Tina Palmer and a couple of other great Canadian musicians had a band called Chelsea Bridge. So a little nod to that fabulous piece of Canadian jazz history and to the great Billy Strayhorn. This is Chelsea Bridge. Chelsea Bridge by the great Billy Strayhorn. Yeah, yeah. Thank you. All right. I always try to have a message of love for you, and I'm not sure that I have a lot of content to figure out in my message of love, except that, as I tell you at the end of my show every week, I love you all, and I really appreciate you listening and joining me in this show. I mentioned that last week I said, you know, democracy matters, and thinking a lot about the election in the United States, and there's been a lot of celebration about the fact that Joe Biden won that election. I can't say it's all that exciting to think about Joe Biden as president, but it's a whole lot more exciting to think about Joe Biden as the president than Donald Trump as the president. But Donald Trump hasn't conceded that election yet. And there are about 70 million people who voted for Donald Trump. And those people, for the most part, are very well armed. So I just want all of us to remember that and remember going through the world with a bunch of love is a much, much healthier and safer way to go. And I wish that for all of you. And I wish that for the United States. And I wish for a peaceful transition to a new administration in that country. And particularly to my friends in the U.S. who might be listening. I'm thinking about you a lot. And I hope that we get there. And to those of us in the rest of the world who know how much of that, how much that country exerts influence over all of our lives. Yeah. I love you. Stay safe. Wear a mask. And let's hope that democracy comes to the USA sometime really soon. I'm going to play one more tune. As usual, it's going to be a long one. It's going to be a loop out. And as I mentioned, it's another dedication to Dave, whose birthday... we are still celebrating. It was yesterday, but I believe in celebrating birthdays for a week or two in each direction. So at least the next day, we'll keep that one going. I mentioned I did some research. I have to tell you, I got a great story from my very good friend, Tony Boston. Now, again, if you watch regularly and if you read the comments, you'll know that Tony and Dave are friends and they're often saying hi to each other on the side of the page. And I don't want to reveal too much. I kind of mixed the story up, and I got it straightened out from Tony. And I'll just say that really the song that I would love to be playing for you and for Dave's birthday to end this show is a tune called Black Tiger, which was composed by Dave and Tony and performed at a free festival at Kelvin Grove Bandstand in Glasgow many years ago. It seems that that song has been consigned to history, and at least to hear Tony tell this tale, that's probably a good thing. But there's a very, very funny story to be told about that one. So anyway, that's not the song we're going to get. But in my research about what would be the best birthday dedication for Dave, David Byrne and the Talking Heads were at the top of every list. That's pretty challenging music to play all by yourself. What a genius he is, David Byrne, and what an amazing band that was. I'm going to do a tune that I kind of know that I've mentioned her already, Rebecca Campbell, who's the singer in this band, the special interest group, sings. We do this tune. It's on this record. Go to Bandcamp, order this record. I'm really proud of this record. We mash this Talking Heads tune up with a tune by Bruce Coburn called If I Had a Rocket Launcher. And Rebecca sings the Talking Heads tune. I'm going to take a run at it, dangerous though that may be. But that's a bit of a mashup that tries to pay honor to the experience of the First Nations of the Americas dealing with the invasion of the new North Americans, the people who came from Europe and have really dominated the economy and the culture and the environment for far too many hundreds of years and done too much damage. So for Dave and for all of you, here is by David Byrne and the Talking Heads, Listening Wind. Thank you.
Village from a nearby hill. Mojik thinks of days before Americans came. He stirs the foreigners in growing numbers. He sees the foreigners in fancy houses. He dreams of days that he can still remember now. In his quivering hands, Mojik sends a package to the American man. Softly he glides among the streets and alleys. Up comes the wind that makes them run for cover. He feels the time is surely now or never more. Wind in my heart, dust in my head, dust in my head. Wind in my heart, wind in my heart. Come to drive them away, come to drive them away. Mojik plants devices through the free trade zone.
He feels the wind is lifting up his people. He calls the wind to guide him on his mission. He knows his friend, the wind is always standing by. Mojik smells the wind that comes from far away. Mojik waits for news in a quiet place. He feels the presence of the wind beside him. He feels the power of the past behind him. He has the knowledge of the wind to guide him on. The wind in my heart, the wind in my heart, dust in my head, wind in my heart, wind in my heart. Drive them away, come to drive them away. Thank you. Thanks for joining me. Happy birthday, Dave. Thanks to all of you sending requests, all of you sending love on the page. I miss you. I love you. I'll see you soon.